Hi, in this tutorial we will create realistic, fluffy materials in V-Ray. We will check out the new sheen effects in the new V-Ray 5, learn how to displace fabric patterns, and finalize our shaders with some V-Ray fur. So let's first check out the final result in here, and since I recently became a father, I thought I'd just duplicate one of my daughter's toys and try to make it as furry, fluffy, and fabric-y as possible. As usual, you can always find my demo scenes and bonus videos on Patreon. And now let's jump to 3ds Max and see how we can use V-Ray 5 in order to generate these kind of materials. So here we have a scene with a basic lighting setup in place, and if you want to know how to generate these kind of basic lighting setup, there's a tutorial that you can find in my channel. Now we have here our trusted shading dummy that you might know from previous tutorials, but since it's not the ideal model to generate these kind of fabric looking effects, I have an additional geometry in here that I now unhide in order to try to make something that looks a little bit more fabric-y. Yeah, and at the moment it doesn't really look very convincing yet because it's like kind of glossy and it looks more like some reflective plastic plane. So that's not really what we want in this case. So we could first just dial down the glossiness in here, for example, to a value of 0.4. This will already help a little bit by not having these kind of very sharp reflections, but it still doesn't really look totally convincing yet. So I have a bump map in here that I will try to enable. And with this, we can see, I hope it's visible in the YouTube compression, that I have now these kind of patterns in here. But one last thing would be missing, and this is this kind of appearance, like there would be these kind of tiny hairs in here, which are catching the highlights. So luckily in V-Ray 5, there's a new option in the V-Ray material, which is called here the sheen parameters. And there's basically just these two parameters here that you can tweak in order to make the fabric look much more convincing. So in order to enable it, you have to choose a different sheen color in here, anything other than black. Let's just go all the way here to white first. And then you can immediately see that we have like this kind of effect that appears here on the edge. And that looks a little bit like there's these kind of tiny microfibers in here, which are catching the highlight and will make the material look much more soft and much more fluffy. So the other value is this sheen glossiness value in here. And if you go higher, for example, then you will see that this highlight here will shrink a little bit. So it will make it smaller in here. And if you go, for example, to lower values like 0.6, you can see that overall in this scene now, this whole effect becomes kind of overwhelming, but at the same time, it also looks like very fluffy and very like fabric-y. So you can try to find some value that kind of matches your requirements. For me, I think this kind of value here, 0.7, works quite well with this scene. And now we can check out in the render elements how we can separate this kind of effect. So if we go here to the render globals and in the render elements, then we can see in this scene I already have some kind of render elements set up, but there's these additional sheen elements, those four here. So let me add this, and then we will start a new rendering and see what will happen. And now we have those render elements. So those are the ones that we set up before. So here's the specular, for example. This combines the whole specular for the whole material. But if we just want to see the specular for the sheen, we have now this sheen specular element and the sheen reflection element in here. So there you can tweak the effect further on in compositing. And there's also an additional layer for this filter and then one for the glossiness in case you need it. So now that we have those kind of basic concepts out of the way, let's switch to our toy from the introduction and implement these kind of concepts on a more interesting subject. So this one right here is our toy model. As you can see at the moment, it doesn't look at all like some fabric material because for now we just use this default V-Ray material with just a gray diffuse color in there. And the first step that I want to do is to give it this kind of characteristic pattern. And there's basically two ways to do it. The first way would be to do it just what we did before using a bump or a normal map. But because I want to have like these kind of bigger details here for the fabric on there, I think the better way in this case would be to use a displacement map. And that's what we're just gonna do now. So this website here, textures.com, I can really recommend in order to get some quite high quality PBR materials. And in this PBR materials category here, there's the subcategory ropes, ducts, and cables. And if we go in here, there's this free downloadable rope in here. And once we click this, I just use like this height map in here, 16-bit TIFF, download this in 2K. And that's all the placement map that we're gonna use in this tutorial. So now that we have the texture, we can start to set up this placement. You can see I separated the body here in two different parts. So this one here is for the blue parts of the body. And then this one here is for the white fabric parts of the body. Let's start with this one in here and let's add a V-Ray displacement modifier. And if you want to know more details about how to use the V-Ray displacement modifier, there's another tutorial in my channel that you can find. So for now, we just use everything here with these kind of values in here. Let's add a new composite map in here. And then let's drag this composite map here into our material editor. And now we can just use a V-Ray bitmap in order to load the displacement map that we just downloaded in here. Then once we do this, we can see that there's something happening here on the surface, but it's not necessarily the thing that we want yet. Let's first increase the result here to, for example, 0.5 centimeters. You can see that there's something happening, but at the same time, it also seems to have these kind of issues here. And that's because this model here has some UV borders. So how do we get rid of this? So either we can make a proper UV for this thing here, but because we're lazy, we just use a V-Ray triplanar texture, which actually works also with displacement maps. And then we can choose, like for example here, 12.5 centimeters. Now we can see we have now these kind of fabric pattern in here, which already looks quite good, but there are still some additional things that we have to tweak in order to make it look even better. So now we'll first rename here this map to triplanar big. Then we will go up one level and to just make sure that everything is loaded correctly. So since the displacement map we just downloaded just contains raw data, we have to make sure that this color space transfer function here in the V-Ray bitmap is set to none. And once we do that, you will see that this displacement here now looks different and looks much better because now the map is loaded in the correct way. And now I only have to adjust this shift value in here in order to make sure that we don't get additional volume that we don't want. We just need to make the negative half of this amount value in here, and then we will make sure that we don't get additional value. Now I want to use exactly the same V-Ray displacement modifier and use it for here, these arms, ears and stuff. So I copy this and then I paste it as an instance in here. And now we will see that we have exactly the same kind of pattern here for those parts. But now instead of using the same kind of scaling here for those parts, I want to use the same map, but just have a smaller scaling for these parts in here. And that's where our composite here comes into play. So we will add a new composite layer. Then we'll copy exactly the same kind of map in here, put it on top as a copy. And then inside here, this triplanar big, we will just rename it to triplanar small. And then we choose a different size in here, for example, size of 4 centimeters. Now we'll see we will overall get a much smaller scaling for this map in here. Now we just need to find a way to have the small scaling here for the arms and ears and stuff, and the bigger scaling here for the main body. And for this, we just go back here to our original composite and add a map in here, which is a V-Ray multi subobject texture map. So this one in this case will go by face material ID, and we just need to look for one face material ID. For example, we use face material ID of 2, and then this one here will be pure white and the default color will be pure black. And now we just need to add the material ID of 2 here for our arms and ears. And if we do this, then this multi sub texture will act as a mask and will apply like this smaller scaling pattern here on those parts, and then the bigger scaling pattern here on those body parts. So now we kind of finished with the displacement here for our model. The next step is to work a little bit on the shader itself. At the moment, we just have this gray diffuse color in here, but we can also use this multi subobject texture in here in order to generate different kind of texture maps here or different kind of colors for those two different parts. So similar like what we just did with the displacement map, we will also just choose total IDs of 1 here, then go by face material ID, make sure that this one here is searching for material ID number 2. And then this value here represents the color of our arms, face and so on. And this one here is the color for our body. So now I just paste inside the correct values in order to just not having to find them again. And after I pasted those values in, we're basically finished here with our diffuse map. So now we can work on the shader itself, and let's first increase here the reflection to pure white to have some kind of reflection. And at the moment, of course, it looks way too glossy. So let's just dial back here the glossiness to a very low value, for example, 0.4. and now it already looks much better. But now the key part again will be to bring back these kind of sheen parameters here. So we just choose a sheen color here of pure white again. And you can see we will get these kind of like nice reflections here on the edges. And now it's just a question of finding the right kind of sheen glossiness. So for this, I will just go a little bit lower here with the sheen glossiness to a value of 0.6 to spread out the highlight a little bit further. And now basically in terms of shader, that's as far as I will take it in this video tutorial in here. And now as a little bonus, let's add a little bit of fur here on top of the material to just finish everything off. So without going into too much detail, because there will be our own tutorial on how to use V-Ray fur, there's these two different V-Ray fur objects that you can just align to two different surfaces. So one is here for the blue fur and one is here for this white fur. And then inside here, you can just dial in some very quick parameters basically. So once I selected this, there's just some very simple basic parameters in here with a very simple V-Ray hair material applied to it. And then you can get some actually quite nice result, as you can see, because it kind of breaks up here all of those edges. So you can see we don't have like these kind of very sharp edges in here. And it also helps to smooth out the displacement a little bit, that by itself can look a little bit harsh. So those two different elements, one would be the displacement here of our geometry, and the other thing would be the additional fur that we added on top will generate here our final looking fabric. And I think like this, it looks quite nice, quite fluffy and quite convincing. So that's it for this tutorial. I hope you liked it. As said, if you want to download the scene and try it out by yourself, you can find this over on my Patreon, among many other of my scenes that you can use to try out and to train and so on. So check out this if you're interested in that. And other than this, check out my other videos that I did and hit like if you like this video, if you want to see more of this kind of stuff. And if you didn't like it, give me a dislike and tell me what I can improve. So see you next time in the next tutorial, and take care.